right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive studio. And joining me now is Andrew Pollard, the CEO of Blackrock Gold. And Andrew, it's great to see you. How are you?
You know what? So far, so good. It's good to be here. And by here, I mean my apartment, which I haven't left for the last 2 weeks now. But yeah, so far, so good. And it's nice to see some meaningful declines across the numbers, you know, out there with respect to COVID. So hopefully we can keep that trend up.
Absolutely. Very important. We want to talk a little bit about your company because you've had quite a bit of news over the last couple of weeks that we want to address. First off, news out this morning that you've added another member to your board, a man named David Laing, who has quite the track record as he joins your board.
Yeah. So, you know, listen, at the end of the day, mining companies come down to two things, and that's projects and people. You know, we're focused on, you know, how do we position ourselves so we come out of this downturn here with a stronger foundation than we had going into it. And yeah, we made a change to our board this morning with the addition of David Laing. Might not be a household name to your viewers, but David's worked alongside some of the biggest names in the industry for the past two decades. He's worked with Ross Beaty, Frank Giustra, Neil Woodyer, and he's been a part of some very high-profile teams and has a background that's just... You know, he's put more mines into production than anyone that I can that I can think of right now. And his skill set is a mine developer and a mine operator, and it's the perfect augmentation to our board because we actually just acquired an option on past producing Silver District in Nevada, and we're going to be able to put his technical expertise to good use.
Yeah, let's talk about that because you just completed the sale of that. So tell me a little bit about how excited you are about this.
Yeah, well, listen, this is something that we're very excited for. And, you know, as we said, we want to come out of this downturn stronger than ever before. And we made this acquisition. It's an option to purchase. We got this option done when it was announced. It was announced the same day that the World Health Organization issued a global pandemic warning. So, you know, they say timing's everything, and the market really hasn't taken notice of what we've done. But we've consolidated for the first time in about six decades, one of the most significant silver districts in North America. And the best part is it's in the middle of Nevada. We're surrounded, we're on the Walker Lane, and we've got our hands on the largest consolidated claim package in what's known as the Tonopah Silver District, which between 1900 and 1928 produced 174 million ounces of high-grade silver and nearly 2 million ounces of gold. And really, it's completely been untouched from modern exploration. The last group to hold the package that we do was Howard Hughes back in the 1960s. So we now have an advanced asset, a past producer with some wildly compelling drill targets now under our domain. We completed our option deal with Ely Gold Royalties last week. And now we've got this brownfield addition to the portfolio. And I mean, listen, when they stopped mining some of these veins, I mean, one of them was 24 meters thick. It was producing at over 700 gram per ton silver. Now, those are the sorts of grades that we're interested to go back, and we want to hit it hard with an RC program this summer. But, you know, unlike Silver Cloud, you know, which is a pure discovery-driven project, which we're trying to piece together, and we think the upside potential is bananas. With Tonopah, I mean, this is right on your nose. Like, you know, we've got five different vein extensions, which we can pick up right where past miners left off. We know the strike, we know the dip, and we're just going to go. And that this is much more of an adding ounces proposition than having to be really, you know, discovery driven. So it changes our risk profile entirely, but it also ties in to what we're doing, which is low sulfidation, epithermal district scale positions in Nevada. And yeah, we're excited to see what we can do here.
While we're here, we should get an update on Silver Cloud because you did have some drill holes recently, including one of the one you went down the deepest, which was over 678 meters.
Yeah, that's if you know, I'd get a nosebleed if I was looking down that high. But with Silver Cloud, I mean, listen, we're doing the first modern exploration on this since, you know, Teck and Placer Dome were exploring it 15 years ago. We did an initial program in December where we have now striked together 250 meters of strike in an area called Northwest Canyon. We've got three different touch points on that with grades that we've encountered. We hit a meter and a half of 8.3 gram per ton gold. It lines up perfectly with a former Placer intercept, which was a meter and a half of 12 grams per ton. And we had another lower grade hit a long strike. So what we realized when we did that was we hit the system right as we anticipated, but we hit it at the very top of the epithermal system. So all we did was we got the drill back at site. We went right back to the same pad where we were drilling from previously, and we wanted to test the down dip extension of this. So we have now gone deeper than anyone has ever gone at Silver Cloud. We hit straight into the core of this thing, and we encountered an absolutely thick volcanic rock package. In fact, it lines up with another thing we just did, which was an enhanced gravity survey across the whole project. And that sort of indicated that we've got a graben structure cutting across the western half of our project. And we confirmed that in the drill. This is significant because it bears an eerily similar structural characteristic to what is found at the Midas mine, which is by far the largest mine on the Northern Nevada Rift. And that's directly on trend of us, 15 kilometers to the north. So we've got this great structural architecture, this massive volcanic rock package, which is very favorable conditions to hopefully hosting a large resource if we can get there. But what we're doing is we're drilling straight into it. We hit, as we outlined in the news release, four different zones below 330 meters that were at least 3.5 meters thick. One of those was an 18-meter zone where we encountered sulfide breccias and quartz veinlets. And yeah, we're very excited to see what the assays come back with in terms of grades. But our understanding of this structural of this area that we're in is just growing leaps and bounds with every hole that we're drilling. And you know, every new piece of data, we're getting these new puzzle pieces added to the framework of what we're trying to put together. And it's in terms of upside, it's looking better than ever. So yeah, we're excited to continue walking forward with Silver Cloud. We should have these assays back hopefully towards the end of the month here. And hopefully timing lines up well, and maybe we'll see it turn the corner from a market perspective in early May, which we'll have a lot of ammo ready to unleash both with the assays and what we're doing at Tonopah in terms of targeting.
Well, it sounds like it's an exciting time for you. Thanks very much for the update. Stay safe, and we'll talk again real soon.
Perfect. Thank you very much.
All right. It's Andrew Pollard, the CEO of Blackrock Gold.